This field research that we have done this year in continuity with the work that we have done last year is based on the desire to listen and understand the living and the working condition of the citizens of Europe. In this edition, we have taken some examples of conflict and resistance that in the recent years marked by the war, the pandemic, have crossed countries such Italy, Spain, and France. We hope that we contribute with this small little example to listen a voice that is too often obscured and underestimated.
For the Italian case of the research, we choose to focus on factory workers. So we involved the workers of Acciai Speciali Terni, which is a pivotal player in the Italian industrial sector, and workers of Acciaierie had a strong working class identity in the past. However, by giving them the voice, the study find out how hard is to mobilize nowadays due to the labor fragmentation inside the factory and due to the uncertainty of life conditions of the workers in a global and financialized economy. So if you want to know more, you can download the report from the Transform Europe website.
Dalla nuova AST mi attendo sostenibilità ambientale per la città e per il territorio, rispetto per i diritti dei lavoratori, aumento degli attuali livelli occupazionali e un salario adeguato per le altre professionalità che si trovano in fabbrica.
As some of you might know, public healthcare doctors in Madrid have been on strike between November 22 until March 23. For this second part of the project Coalition of Labour, we wanted to understand the keys of the labour conflict from the perspectives of the workers themselves. That's why I've talked to a group of mobilised doctors in Madrid to ask them about the motivations and demands to the strike, the organisation strategies, the impact of the COVID pandemic, among other issues. So if you want to get to know more about the interesting results of this research that we conducted, you can now access and read the report online.
Es difícil movilizar a los médicos y a los profesionales sanitarios, pero tras la crisis de la COVID de 2020 y pensando que vendrían a poner soluciones y realmente vendrían a aumentar presupuestos para lo que realmente importa, para la sanidad de todos, y ver que no ha sido así, ver que todo el peso del sistema de salud sigue recayendo sobre los profesionales sin que las autoridades sanitarias y las administraciones hagan su parte, se ha producido un despertar médico, una unión, en pro de defender las condiciones de ejercicio y una sanidad de calidad para los pacientes. Y bueno, ha sido todo un privilegio poder estar al lado de estos médicos y bueno, empezar a sentar las bases para mejorar las condiciones de la profesión.
As part of the Transform Europe project, Coalition of Labour, Two Worker Voices, I have met a group of yellow vest activists involved in the north of Paris. And we've discussed about the evolution of their living condition, about their working condition as well, 5 years after the beginning of the Yellow Vest movement and in the context of inflation related to war in Ukraine. And we've also discussed about their political preoccupation and political activities as well, and especially their implication in the social movements against the pension reform in France.
Je suis Nadège, je suis assistante de direction de métier, mais j'ai pas mal galéré avec le Covid, avec le gouvernement actuel, avec, enfin, bref. les galères, j'ai connu.
Moi, c'est Evelyne, je suis retraitée de l'éducation nationale. Je suis une militante gilet jaune. Voilà, et rebelle.
Je suis Angelo, gilet jaune de la première heure. Moi, je suis à fond dans les gilets jaunes. C'est bon, il n'y a rien qui change depuis 4 ans. Avec le gouvernement actuel, il n'y a rien qui se passe. Quoi. Donc, tant qu'on n'a rien obtenu, on sera toujours dehors.
Moi, c'est Agnès. Je suis avec les gilets jaunes depuis le début du mouvement également. Ce qui m'a fait vraiment sortir, c'était l'éveil d'autant de personnes que j'attendais depuis de nombreuses années. Donc voilà, active depuis 4 ans.
Pour un monde meilleur, même si Macron ne veut pas, nous on est là.